the thing that people most know about is the filtration capacity. So sponges are animals, but the way they live is by filtering out water, primarily bacteria and small particles from the water. And so they're like giant pool filters. And in fact, there's estimates that in a healthy sponge community, the entire bay is filtered in about 3 days. A sponge-rich habitat is it's like a rock band playing or something. It's really loud and a lot of voices underwater. And a lot of organisms actually use those sounds to find nursery habitats.
We take small concrete bricks and just attach that little piece of sponge to a brick with a little zip tie, and then we leave it sitting in the bottom, just in an open sandy area, and that sponge will then heal and begin to grow another sponge. For about a decade now, we've been working on trying to understand the ecology behind restoring sponges, so how we restore sponges, where we put them, how many sponges we put, different species. I mean, we've got a good handle on that to date, but one of the things that sort of the overarching goal that we've always had is not just to return sponges to Florida Bay where they've been lost, but to try and bring hard-bottom communities back to their full ecological function. When I say ecological function, I mean things like the return of the lobsters, the return of stone crabs, the return of snapping shrimps and things that live within those sponges, and all of the organisms that make a functioning hard-bottom ecosystem. Some of the work that we're hoping to do in the future as well is looking at resistance to blooms, and the idea that perhaps there, when we're swimming around and we're visiting some of these sites after a bloom has occurred, we're struck by the occasions where many sponges will be dead, and then there'll be a few individuals that don't seem to be harmed. And is there a genetic component there? Is there some kind of a physiological component that gives those sponges a resistance to it? So that's sort of one of the next steps, hopefully, is to add that genetic component to see if we can't use sponges that are more resistant and resilient to the blooms than others.